A DJ Z, the gospel defender, man, a real Christian, not a pretender. More to not understand, say God for everybody, no matter what agenda. You know, say boy, God sweet like honey, devil sour like lime. We need to big up Christ all the time. You know, say as Christian, we need to make our light shine. Hear this.
We need to find our passion and embrace our purity. What is our passion? Take Christ lead the way and then we will know. We need to find our passion and embrace our purity. Yeah, what is our passion? Let Christ lead the way and then we will know.
Find your passion, let your light so shine. Before men, that means before mankind. Seek after Christ to the Savior divine. Take it not to the beat but the rhyme. What is it for a man to gain the whole world? I feel lose him so sick of diamonds and pearl. A passion must involve Christ, cause he is the way, man, the truth from his dead come alive.
We need to find our passion and embrace our purity. What is our passion? Let Christ lead the way and then we will know. We need to find our passion and embrace our purity. Yeah, what is our passion? Let Christ lead the way and then we will know.
Purity, how can I embrace that? It's not easy and as a youth I can attest to that. It's a fact, but it can be done. Now let me show you now, come. That strength is made complete in man's weakness. Trials come our way just to bring success. To remain pure, we have to give off our best. To keep our purity is a part of God's test.
We need to find our passion and embrace our purity. What is our passion? Let Christ lead the way and then we will know. We need to find our passion and embrace our purity. Yeah, what is our passion? Let Christ lead the way and then we will know.
So we're going to be inviting the Karen Ennis drama team to come. And as soon as the team is through, we're going to be going into our concert section. All right? All right. So let's just listen up as the drama team, they come and do their thing. Oh, boy. Sure. You know, hallelujah. Me camera with that debating, yeah?
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Mike.
Why my school ever come with English now? Them couldn't ask me for social study or mathematics, cause my bad panda.
Keisha!
Hello? Yes, yes, yes! What happened?
Keisha!
Come now, Susie! Sure!
Girl, come and open this door. You know I can't touch no door. I just did my manicure.
Oh, boy.
Keisha, come and give me a hug, baby.
Hi, sweetheart. Oh, boy.
How you doing?
I'm here, you know, girl, getting ready for the debate. You can't help me. You know, you're such an eloquent speaker, and you have the English pot already and thing. So, you can't give me a few tips for the debate?
Oh, Keisha, you know, I love you so much.
Yeah, I know.
And you're my friend.
I know.
But this is a competition, and I am not a psychological institution.
I never ask you that. I ask you for your help.
Guess what? Girl, I love you, but guess what? Read some encyclopedia. I better yet, Google it.
Google what?
Google English.
And you call yourself my friend. Anyways, who is this lady? Excuse me, no? You can't come in my house and take up so much space. Hi, beautiful young lady. Welcome to my El Casa.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. You know, so I come from country. I'm getting everything English, you know, ma'am.
Susie.
Keisha.
Where you get her from?
Listen, don't talk to she.
No, you can't tell me that she's in my...
No, hold on. You see, every word that comes out of her mouth, it embarrasses me. I don't like being her nowhere.
Why you walk with her?
Because she kind of look pretty, and you know, I...
Miss Al, me want to do it now, just all you have to do is just come over my yard with an English book, and then I just help her read the English if
no,
you want.
Hi, excuse me again. By the way, I hear you over there speaking Spanish. You don't even know English. It's not El Casa, it's La Casa.
So what? I make English and Spanish. El Casa, La Casa, any type of casa is me say so. You know what? Let me come out of my house. Can I go on like I wouldn't own it?
Listen, didn't I tell you not to talk? What is wrong with you? Everywhere you go, you're embarrassing me with your butu talk.
Sure. What kind of homework this? The importance of English and me can't even chat it properly. No, because me come from country, they always take advantage of me, so. Sure. You know what? Me go in that room, go study, yeah, man. Sure.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am your host, DC, or rather known as Slim. Yeah? Okay, I want to welcome you all to the 2011 English debate, right? Our winners today will win a trip for two to, what's that place called? Oh, Hope Gardens, right? Yeah. Hope Gardens, and the trip is basically so that you can see the wonderful animals that Jamaica has, right? Okay, now, the stipulations for this debate is that you cannot chat patois, because right now, you know, you know, English we are dealing with, so English one. So we don't want no patois, no misuse of the English language. And basically, if you can't chat good, don't come from stage. But you know, you know, our first debater is Susie from Kingston.
Oh, I'm so glad to be here. Thank you very much. Thank you. No autographs.
You can start now.
Master of ceremonies, judges, fellow opponents, good evening. The English language is fundamental to the development of our society. It is utilized in every aspect of our society. It is highly recognized by teachers, students, parliamentarians, and the most honorable Cliff Twong. Nobody cannot cross it. But my fellow judges and opponents, I understand it, so I can cross it. My life is one that is cantankerous in every exaggerated, in every areas. That's why I am affirmative of this conclusive element that I am unambiguous and I am crossing it. Thank you.
Whoa.
No autographs. Thank you very much. Thank you.
All right, come on from the stage. Yes, like I was saying, a lot of big words from our contestant, Susie. Now, you've heard her, and basically she thinks she's all that. But our next component is here to challenge that. Now we have Keisha from Portland. She country, but deal with her, nice.
Thank you very much. Good evening, judges, chairman and friends. Good evening. Yes. English comprised of similes, figurative language and literature, and literal English, excuse me. English is one of the popular and most needed subjects in society. I thank you.
Well, that was really nice. Yeah. Okay, calm down, people, calm down. Okay, our next contestant. This contestant is from St. Anne. Okay. Yes, her name is Tammy. And she will be presenting. Let's see if she can beat the rest.
Thank you. thank you. Good evening, judges. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The English language is very important to people in many parts of the world because it is their native language. I will now proceed to my first point. English language is important to the world today because it is very important in communicating to communities, companies, schools, and the global society.
My second point. Now, many students would learn the vocabulary and try to put many words together to create a proper sentence. It amazes me how many words some of my colleagues may know, but they cannot create a proper sentence. Isn't that true? The reason is because they didn't study phrases. Now, many young people would learn a language. They can learn both words and phrases together. I want you to say to young people, you are from Westwood. You are the head girl of this school, and I'm very proud of you. Where is Crystal? Crystal is the head girl of Woolmans. Come here, Crystal. And we have a lot of young people who are rising to the top of their school, and in their school is saying, go passion and? Purity. So could you please tell these young ladies, what does passion and purity mean to you, and where you see going at Westwood?
Good afternoon, everyone. Okay, my name is Keona Bailey. Keona, like owner of the key. You get it? So it's Keona, right? Okay, passion and purity, it means so much to me. I can't even explain most times, but what I can tell you is that the first conference I went to at St. Hilda's, I remember I was there, I was worshiping so freely, young people, nobody was watching, nobody cared, you understand? All persons cared about is worshiping God and releasing all that was happening in their lives. And so from that day, I decided that I have to always be a part of this movement because it is very important. Also, I love music, right? And from that first conference, there was a big thing on the music issue, right? And I sing a lot, but I don't always sing gospel music. And like what Mrs. Ennis was saying, you know, it's really the things that we feed our minds on. And so after that conference, I even wrote, if you go on the website, you can see I have a testimony there. After that conference, I decided to remove all the dirty music from my iPod, every single one of them. It did not happen the day after the conference, but right now, today, many of the girls there can tell you I have 272 gospel music on my iPod.
Very good. Come on, put your hands together for her. No, Yannick, these answers have to be very brief. Yannick, how do you deal with the urge? How do you deal with sexual temptations when the girls are bringing it on? How do you deal with that? Quickly.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Yannick Nesbitt. The question on how to deal with sexual temptation, first of all, how I deal with it is basically by praying. I mean, you walk around and you see stuff. You see different girls, and they'll be wearing some stuff or not wearing what they're supposed to be wearing at the same time. You pray. You say a quick prayer in your heart, and you look away. Don't bother thinking, you know, I can handle this. I can look at it, and nothing happens. That doesn't work. Look away, say a prayer, and it's pretty simple. That's it.
Come on, quickly. Dundas is Mr. Cadet. He has an article in this Passion and Purity book, and he's going to be a military officer. I want him to tell you what are his views. Very shortly, what are his views on passion and purity? He's the passion and purity rep for Woolmans Boys for this year.
All right, good afternoon, folks. Passion and purity is really dear to me. My whole love for passion and purity is that I love to be in an atmosphere where young people can worship God freely. Don't think about anything around them, but just worship God in spirit and in truth. And since my first time at Calabar, I really developed a love for passion and purity. And speaking to Mrs. Norman, I got involved and continue to push it throughout the school. And I just want to encourage everyone to stay close to passion and purity, get involved. It's a really good initiative. Bless.
Come on, Mr. Calabar, they have an active focus group and two supportive teachers. Come quickly. These boys, 11 of them traveled to Portland and overnight over there with their teachers and had a wonderful time, and they have covenanted to take on passion and purity. Just briefly, what is happening at Passion and Purity, at Calabar Re Passion and Purity, quickly?
Well, good afternoon, everybody. Re Passion and Purity at Calabar, indeed. I was introduced to this, the focus group at my school last year when I was in lower six. And indeed, it did so much positives for me. One of the things that it helped me, along with the help of my focus group leader, Miss Archer, it prompted me to embrace my passion for writing. And I remember one day I was sitting and I was meditating upon the Lord. And out of the depths of my heart, I said, "Oh Lord, my God, my love, thou art sweeter than a thousand sweet melodies upon still waters." And you know, when I said that, my heart began to melt in the presence of God. And that's one of the positives that Passion and Purity has granted unto me. And I'm really grateful for that.
Passion and Purity is giving us a generation of holy men who not bow to no Satan. Somebody say, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Come on, Crystal. Crystal is the head girl at Woolmers. What's happening at Woolmers? By the way, Woolmers not better than any other school, you see? I'm a homewood girl. But Woolmers is the first school in the Caribbean. And from that foundation, the first school in the Caribbean, God is pushing something around. Will Miran stand up and say, yeah, yeah? What is happening at Woolmers Re Passion and Purity? Quickly.
Hi, everybody. Everything is happening at Woolmers. Every single thing you can think about. Our focus group, led by Mrs. Norman, we're currently looking at an initiative to make Passion and Purity a long-term thing for the girls at Woolmers. We're looking to build, and the boys, we're looking to build something in the future, like a home, a prep school, something with a brand, Passion and Purity, because we are passionate and pure. We believe in passion and purity. And apart from that, we're just preaching the word. We're telling other people about passion and purity. We're just spreading the word all about.
Quickly, Rocky is the one that keeps Passion and Purity rocking at UTEC. Russian Rocky, just say hi and tell them briefly. Because Rocky was the one who called me from Money Teachers College and said, "I've got to get there." I say, "Well, take a bus." And the next time she called and she said, "We have a van load." Guess what? Tell them what's happening at UTEC quickly.
All right, at UTEC now, we're getting off the ground. We had a group at UTEC, we're transferring to UTEC to have the same kind of continuity. You know, you're in high school, you're on fire with passion and purity, and you realize, I leave high school and it's like the only thing I can do now is go to the conference. We're trying that continuity, so at UTEC, you can still have that same support base, that same kind of spiritual realm, that same kind of connection where you can have people you work with who are with you in the whole trend of being passionate and being pure, even when you leave high school and you know what to want to do, being passionate about getting to the tertiary level in getting to your career.
Auntie Jackie, come here quickly. Auntie Jackie, come here quickly. I want you to choose one girl from your school and ask that girl one quick question.
Shade, where is Shade? Shade is such a passionate young lady. She loves the Lord with all her heart. Shade, just tell them about your experience with Passion and Purity, what it has meant for you in your personal life. Quickly, like a half minute.
Good evening, everyone. Well, Passion and Purity, believe me, it encompasses my life, literally. My phone has Passion and Purity written on it. My laptop has Passion and Purity written on it. Everything I own has Passion and Purity written on it. Why? Because I want to use it to minister to other people, right? When persons look at my bag, they see my pin on it, and they're like, "What is this?" And then all of a sudden, it's like goose pimples just take over me because I feel the presence of God. That is what Passion and Purity means to me. Whenever I take up the book, even if I give it to someone, believe me, the presence of God is just there. It is just there. And I just see Passion and Purity as living a life that Jesus would live, right? Embodying Jesus. That's what Passion and Purity means to me.
Hallelujah. Give it up for Shade. Thank you, Shade. We're going to be having a dance, and it's going to be coming to us from the MSOG, Manifested Sons of God. Give it up for MSOG. Give it up for MSOG.
Yeah.
Is God good this afternoon? Oh yes, he sure is.
All right. He was a part of this group.
Uh-huh.
Somebody's supposed to know it.
Uh-huh.
S.O.P. Let's give it up for Lifa!
Lifa! Yeah. Yeah. Passion and purity. Somebody said Jesus! Somebody said Jesus! Yeah! Now, man, we can do better, man. Come on, lift up the mighty name of the Lord. Him are the King of Kings and Him are the Lord of Lords. There is no other God like our Jehovah God. And Jesus will say, "Are we no business about nobody else? We no watch Buddha. We no watch Allah. We no, we darn right don't watch Selassie." And Jesus will say, listen up, listen, listen, listen. We have made Jesus our passion. And it's only through Him and only by His Spirit we can have purity. So no Superman thing. You can't live off of your self-righteousness. A Jesus alone can make you holy. Amen. Remember sit down them for Jesus, just go so. Just go so. Get crazy. Make some crazy face. And Jesus was saying, no. Remember see the soldiers for Jesus, go so. For me, no say not take program from no man, no boy, no girl. And God alone will say, we burn out sex before marriage. One man to a woman, one woman to a man. No homosexuality. No fornication. If Nicholas did there, would I say, what? Back to the owner. Yeah, man. Some of them sit there and them go say for Jesus. For me, know that Jesus is a true God. Because we say, yo, worship cows, now tell me who planned that. You know, she says, it's a scam that. Because when I'm hungry, my God, Burger King, go order your God in our whopper, me name that. Track one. Let's go. Passion and purity. If you have a rug. What, I'm a rug. Yeah. If you have a rug, go so for Jesus. Because I am alone with saying no. One, two, three, God only. We not take program. We not be a fool. Passion and purity, go so. Go so. Somebody said Jesus!
A DJ Z, the gospel defender, man, a real Christian, not a pretender. More than I understand, say God for everybody, no matter what agenda. You know, say boy, God sweet like honey, devil sour like lime. We need to big up Christ all the time. You know, say as Christian, we need to make our light shine. Hear this.
We need to find our passion and embrace our purity. What is our passion? Take Christ lead the way and then we will know. We need to find our passion and embrace our purity. Yeah. What is our passion? Let Christ lead the way and then we will know. Find your passion, let your light so shine. Before men, that means before mankind. Seek after Christ to the Savior divine. Take it not to the beat but the rhyme. What is it for a man to gain the whole world? I feel lose him so sick of diamonds and pearl. A passion must involve Christ. Cause he is the way and the truth from his dead come alive. We need to find our passion and embrace our purity. What is our passion? Let Christ lead the way and then we will know. We need to find our passion and embrace our purity. Yeah. What is our passion? Let Christ lead the way and then we will know. Purity, how can I embrace that? It's not easy and as a youth I can attest to that. It's a fact, but it can be done. Now let me show you now. Come, that strength is made complete in man's weakness. Try to come our way just to bring success. To remain pure, we have to give up our best. To keep our purity is a part of God. We need to find our passion and embrace our purity. What is our passion? Let Christ lead the way and then we will know. We need to find our passion and embrace our purity. Yeah. What is our passion? Let Christ lead the way and then we will know. Find the passion and embrace our purity. To worship God is our destiny. To find the passion and embrace